Is anybody home? Why my son Christopher was so excited and exuberant to trade me my mini boom for this, which seemed like a larger and more dynamic speaker, but it has a sort of thing going on. And see, I feel like he knew that. And I don't know if y'all seen this little number right here. Excuse me, I'm already 6 feet tall. Bam! Do y'all like this little number? This is my new favorite dress I'm going to wear every day. I'm going to sleep in it. I'm going to put it as like a bathing suit cover up. Like I could wear it with leggings and a shawl in the winter. Like it could be every day. Hey girl, Renee, what are you doing? Y'all want to tell you something about when you're going out. But while we're waiting on them. Hey Lauren, hey Anna. Waiting on a couple people to jump in. We'll have a couple of jump to it music, shall we? Did anybody name this band? Chat on this, which not long because I'm going somewhere, I really am. And we have something going on in downtown Spartanburg tonight that is a spring fling of such, and there's music and there's activities, and that's not where I'm going, but it's very close to there. John, what are you doing, man? John has been traveling the world ever since I've talked to him last. Are you still on your raw vegan, John? That's the question. Yo. Let's have a different song, shall we? You like my look at these things. Are they not? This is mineral fusion polish and it is fantastic. And anyway. Couple things to tell y'all, okay? Now let's get the next song ready because I only have a couple minutes to talk. Really, I do. And I know my hair is kind of like weird, but it's very humid, so really, I don't know. Go with what you got, you know? You get what you get, and you don't pitch a fit. You want to get out? What you gonna do? Do you want to get out? So what I want to tell you is this. Yeah, this thing hisses. I know why Christopher traded me. Number one, if you girls are not getting on board with the heavy lifting. Okay, let me just give you, I'm going to have a whole talk on this. Let's just talk about this. Like you got thighs, right? Okay, they're about the same size, but here's the difference. You start heavy lifting. Lifting, what do I mean by that? You're like squatting back there with the weight belt? No, I'm just talking about like pushing it beyond your limits. And here's the thing. You're squatting and you're doing like this, I call it the click-clack torture machine. It's like you're fixing to take off on a roller coaster and it's like click, 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 click. And then you have to like, and you're bringing it up and you're like, oh my gosh, I cannot. And then you do 12 and then you do four more sets of 12, bam. The point is this. Women are afraid of lifting a little bit heavy because they think they're going to bulk up. Hello, I'm slimmer than ever. And the thing about the thighs is the muscle tone is a different shape. And girls, it's beautiful and it's powerful when you feel strong. And another thing is this, like let's turn on some air conditioning. Let's say you're wearing some cute little, do y'all know what boy shorts are? They're panties, you know, but they're the kind of panties that like your hiney sort of hangs out the bottom, which can be attractive and it can be like really bad. But when you are lifting heavy, what I'm saying is you're lifting heavy, but your butt, and this is not what you would think, is lifting up. Do you understand? Not huge. I don't know if y'all aren't on board with this, but I'm just saying the curves and the muscle tone is beautiful and it does not take much because I've only been going about 2 times a week, about 35 to 45 minutes a time. That is not much time. It's really not if you know what the heck you're doing. And I do because I befriended the gym owner, Mr. John, who is now my new bestest friend, see? So anyway, let's talk about this. If you're going out, and I see a lot of women, and dudes too, but mostly I talk to women, that trip up when they go out. Or even speaking of John, who's on here, he worked with me in one of my groups, and he would go out in different places. And you know, you have to be really, really willing to show up as here I am. Like, what is it you're wanting to do? And knowing that, like, I'm going out tonight, and there might be a Mexican tile floor fiesta dancing situation, and there'll be like chips and salsa and margaritas. Okay, that's not my food. But the point is this, I had a little bit of a green smoothie earlier, which was a little bit of a savory green smoothie, like mostly veggies, but it did not have much fat at all. It had a little bit, like not even a fourth of an avocado. So then when I go to this Mexican fiesta tonight, I know how much avocado I want if I have guacamole and if I watch them make it at the table, or what am I gonna do? The thing is, you can always get veggies and tomatoes or veggies. The point is this, you can go out and do anything, arriving as you with here I am. Doing your thing, you do not have to compromise who you are and what you want for the sake of others. And you also don't have to drag them down about it. You can do your own dang thing and it's powerful. Do y'all know this? Is anybody practicing this? Hey, Kimberly. I got these earrings at, y'all, these are these not the cutest? Look at these, and do y'all not think that this necklace, when they're like short and they're like really light and you can wear it all the time and it barely like, this is like a, it might be a 16 to 18 inch depending on which prongies you put it on. But is that not the cutest? And see, it has like a little flippy side. You could have like, I don't think y'all can see that. I'm more of a gold tone. This is like two sparkle tones. But I got this at TJ Maxx, and I got these at TJ Maxx on clearance for $4. Look at that, make you wanna holler. These are Lucky Brand, which is one of my favorite brands to wear. But anyway, I like stuff that goes with anything, and I have some turquoise earrings that just match this, but these are just very danceable, are they not? You need to move to Southern Cali, woman, who said that? That's where John lives, somewhere on the coast. Venice Beach, maybe. Anyway, so I just wanted to say, no matter what you're doing, you really can show up as you. Do you know that? You really can do different. People are like, well, you know, I can't date, or I can't, you know, go there. Yeah, you can, and you can be the bright light. You can be the disco ball, so to speak, on the dance floor, because here's the thing, everybody else in that place is drunk out of their mind. And when people are drunk, their dance moves are really compromised, but yours, no thank you. Like, you really could, you could be Coyote Ugly getting up on the, I mean, I'm not suggesting that, but let's just say you wanted to. You really, like, could bring it. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I love TJ Maxx for their deals. The thing is, you can also bring your own dressing. Somebody's saying that, Kimberly, I have a dressing called Shake and Take Dressing that's very like a half pint size. You can tuck it in your purse. Say you think, okay, like, you're not gonna be back for a long time. Like, you're really gonna need to prep a little more. But see, this is in my town and I'm in control, you know what I mean? So I can come back and eat more and I'm really not hungry. I'm just not hungry. And so therefore, I'm in control of this situation. Are y'all picking this up? Do y'all wanna talk about anything else? You're afraid of criticism. Who says that? Mark? Yeah, they just don't get it. They're not going to. And here's the thing. You're coming to this life as you. Your self-worth is not measured by the approval of other people. You arrive as here I am, and you will suddenly become a dynamic sunshine in the midst of a bunch of dull down clouds. That's really true. And as long as you don't pack your soapbox, people don't even give a rip. Really, a lot of times when they're questioning you, or back in the day when they used to question me, I would say, well, you know, I'm allergic to a lot of these foods, and so, yeah, or, you know, I've had this situation, and I'm just, and I would just move along, and people are like, okay, whatever. Like, people want to talk about their self, or I'll be like, well, you know, I can't get in any of my summer shorts. I mean, I can, but let's just say I couldn't. I can't get in any of my summer shorts, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I cannot buy a new wardrobe. I'm just like not eating that crap. And people will be like, yeah, I don't need to eat that crap either. You didn't say like, look, I'm a raw vegan. If you're eating people and sentient beings or earth creatures, you're wrong. Do you understand? You're taking a life. Like, nobody asked you to come to the event with your dang soapbox. And furthermore, it's heavy. Like, I am in charge of doing me. Right? And it is brilliant. And I tell you what, you really bring in more flies with honey. You know what I'm saying? Like, when you are a light, a vessel of love and light, it is an undeniable energy, and people want to get on board with that. Maybe they're not ready, and you don't really give a rip. You just want them not to hassle you. You know, you're like, I really feel good. Like, I'm a granny and I am rocking this thing. Like, are you loving me rocking this mini dress as a granny? Like, what are you saying to people, you know? Who cares what people think? You do you. Exactly right. Yeah, but Mark's legit on that, you know, because a lot of people, we all go through that, and I used to go through that. And I'll tell you what, before you're really solid and you know that you know that you know, you can be sidetracked real easy. So put on your blinders, go in as you, prepare to push away from the table with success, feeling like maybe you have to leave the dinner hungry. You're going home and your food lives there, right? It's fine. Or maybe you're a person who's used to drinking when you go out, and you're like, okay, well, here's the thing. So order a soda water, I don't know what you're doing. Well, order a little cranberry spritz or something. So you look like you've got a drink, whatever you normally drink, and you're just like blending in. Like, you don't need to be hassled. You got enough new changes to deal with. I'm just saying, you can go anywhere and do anything. I do not compromise my social calendar for that. My dance card is always full, and nobody minds that I eat low-fat, raw vegan, and have for a dang decade. You see what I'm saying? It's a big deal. Setting up your boundaries, showing up as you, arriving with, here I am, right? Little crunchy, confidence is important. You are right, girl. When you show up with confidence, you know what's more is sexier than anything else? Is somebody showing up with their authenticity out there, with their confidence, with, this is what I do. Yo. Yo, baby. Yo, baby. Yo. Right? Doing your own thing. Hey, Carrie, how are you? You just made my sweet carrot dressing and ever favorite creamy Italian dressing. That's one of my favorites. Hey, Amy. So I just wanted to say that. I just wanted to say that there's no reason you have to compromise. There's no reason you have to stay home. I go anywhere and do anything. I don't even have to pack anything. Because I realize I am not driven around by toxic food addictions, by low-grade addictions, toxic cravings. I'm driven around by my love and light. And it is like a comet that is me, and it has a tail behind it that is long and bright and strong. And no food tastes better than how I feels. No food. You know? Hey, Gerald Lee, how are you, beautiful? You can do this thing, you really can. And it's all about mindset. Maybe it takes you a year. Maybe it takes you a day. You set up the boundaries. You monitor the borders. You show up as you. Here I am, doing my thing. Because nobody else really gives a rip what you're doing. Even if they say they do, they really don't, you know? your husband's family is always trying to get onto some other diet. Exactly. Well, good for them. Like, give them the link to Jenny Craig. Rock on. Like, I don't really give a rip what you're doing. I know what works for me, and it works year after year after year. And frankly, now, decade, and now into the next decade. So here's the thing. Bam. You do you, and I'll do me. And most of all, I'll be free. You see what I'm saying? You know what? Whoever said I just had dewy skin, do you realize that I used to have nodular acne from here down? It was so scarred. It was like a teenage boy who had had like a pizza acne face. And it has smoothed out and regenerated, you know? Alkalize, detoxify, regenerate. Don't you want to be that? Don't you want to be free to have your thoughts and mental clarity? What does it feel like to be healthy? It feels like everything. Because when you lose your health, all you want to regain is your health. Hey, Penny, how are you? I was just talking about healthy skin. I have a video. My daughter clearly doesn't know I'm chatting live. She just called. But, I have a lot of videos, vegan and cruelty-free hair care, vegan and cruelty-free makeup, and vegan and cruelty-free skincare. I use swellskin.net. That is a cleansing bar, okay, natural, and then sea buckthorn oil that's drops, and I use that afterwards. That's all I use, and it's freeing, okay? I am 45 years old. I'm not claiming that my skin is perfect, but it's perfectly imperfect for me. It's perfectly beautiful from where I came from, and I wouldn't trade my experiences for the world, and I wouldn't trade the lines, and I wouldn't trade. No, that is my life track. You know, I don't mind being my age. I embrace it. When somebody says how old you are, I can't trip it out of my mouth fast enough, because it's been my life's journey to become healthy since I was 30 years old. 28 years old did I start losing my health, and now at 45 years old, I rise, butterfly. Fly, you know? So when you have that under your wings and you show up at these things and you arrive as you, your light is undeniable, and people will stop trying to dim that, because guess what? There's no use, right? Y'all got anything else to say? I don't like this speaker, Christopher. Waiting on. Somebody just said Irish moss, and I've got a lot of videos on Irish moss, and that is like a collagen builder for your body. And you can add, I have what is Irish moss, how to prepare it. Type in Irish moss on my channel and you'll see that. And you can add in 1 tablespoon to 2 smoothies a day, and you will start to, my skin is very plump. Like, it used to not be like that, okay? And I wake up like this. I don't have to like ice my eyes or think, what am I gonna wake up to? You know what I'm saying? Devin is contagious, raw energy. It's the real deal. When you don't need any drugs, you don't need any drinks, you don't need any things, you don't need it. All you need is pristine health. You know? The Irish moss wraps are great. Adding that into your regimen, and it's really cheap. And I show you on my channel how to soak it and such like that. Geraldine, girlfriend, this is a mini skirt. This is like a little romper two doll, and I have on these. I mean, I know I'm 6 feet tall, but hello, can you get a load of these, please? You know, I'll tell you something else. I used to dislike my height, and I am 5'10" and a half. And I disliked it. I disliked my hands because they could palm a basketball in your face and squeeze it if you talk about them. And I dislike my feet that are a 9, sometimes a 10, but 11 feels real good. You know what I'm saying? And like, I dislike that. But now I see my hands as the hands that embrace and love and reach and touch and give. You know, and I see my height as uniquely me, and I don't mind putting on 2-3 inch, you know, wedge heels. I don't mind if I'm out with a dude that's only 6 feet tall, and then I'm tall. Okay, so get on board with hanging, like jack up your alpha male confidence, will you? Because coming with confidence, when you're a dude that's only my height, and I can wear these, and you can show up with confidence, you've got something going on, and that's sexy, right? When you can show up as you. You always thought I looked short. Denise, what are you doing, girl? I used to didn't like my height either, and Denise is saying that, and my daddy used to call me Flipper, and he used to tell my mom, well, you know, she's pretty enough for all practical purposes, and stuff like that, and you know, those things really drill in your head, but we can reprogram our thinking, we really can. I know, Geraldine, you and I were the same height, girl. I love being tall now. I love like having broad shoulders, and I love like now having narrow hips and long legs and strong legs. I love that. When I can be in the store standing, and now I walk very tall. I have people tell me sometimes, do you model? Did you used to model? Because I have a very streamlined walk to myself because I am no longer in pain. I am free of that, and I stand with a health confidence like no other, like I never had before, you know? Geraldine is very beautiful, and Geraldine sent me a little video the other day. We were chit-chatting, and I screenshotted that just for myself. I think I sent it to you, but I was like, you know, you're really beautiful. I tell you why she's beautiful, because she has an authentic quality. If y'all don't follow her on Geraldine, Geraldine, she is a YouTube channel, and she is coming into her own on Low Fat Raw Vegan. She's had her first year, now she is proceeding into her second year. Was she perfect? No, because guess what? If you're perfect, if you're never failing, you ain't even trying. Because we can fail our way to success. How is that? Because every stumble you take, it's not a boulder that smashed your face, bloodied your nose, and broke it. No, it was a stumbling stone. And you grabbed up that shiny stone and you put it in your pouch and you remembered why that didn't work for you. And you got on board for moving past that. See what I'm saying? And she's doing that. And you know, I come to y'all from a place where I have feel like I have mastered this. Do I feel like I have no growth to do? No, because I'm not. That would be driven by the ego. I always want to bring in new information, decipher it, and see if it works for me, okay? But she is in a different place than me. You see me, I just talked to somebody, Sandra, earlier. She texted me up. She was like, hey, like I had a half an hour left. You know, it's been a long time. Like, is that time gone? Am I too late? I'm like, girl, no, let's chat now. Can I call you now? She's like, yeah. So we chatted. And I was at the Kerr Market, and she was just saying, like, she was like, Tanya, you know, when I talk to you, you're really, like, real. You're really, like, a real person that's done this. And when I, like, look at your channel and it's growing, and I, you know what, I'm looking at it now, but I never look at that. I never look at how many views. I never look at how many subs. It's irrelevant. All I'm going to do is show love and receive love and give love to get love. Show my thing. Do I have to be like anybody else? Do I have to edit? No, I'm going to do my thing. Authenticity is beautiful. But anyway, I was talking to her on the phone, and she's like, yeah, so like I've, That's you falling. Are you okay? Did you hit your head? So anyway, she was just saying, like, you're really, like, sometimes I look and I'm like, yeah, that's not even real. Like, and then I talk to you and I realize, yeah, you're just like me. And I said, Sandra, I really am. Just like you. You bumped your head, little crunchy. Are you okay, baby? So, yeah. Who's on here? I just want to say that, you know, that I really am. I don't know why she was telling me that, because I've talked to her several times, but it's been a while, and she had like gained some weight back, and she had got married and did some different life situations. Okay, and so now, do different and get different again. It's always there for you. It's the well of health, you know? And if you don't have health, you don't have anything. We put it last, and it needs to be first. When it's first, everything else is easier, you know? Anyway, I just want to say I love you, and I want to say you can go anywhere and do anything. Are you going to eat when you get back? Are you going to take a shake and take dressing? Are you going to, I don't know. The other day I went out to lunch at Whole Foods, and guess what I had? Water and thoughts. And that's all I needed. Because I was in a space where I needed to, I had a ceremonial releasing of some things. And what was funny is, after the ceremony, I must have left the debate open, because it swirled back around just in the last few days. But being in the moment, thinking like something out of this world is where I live. Nothing tastes better than how I feel feels. Nothing. And nothing will make me fall from raw. Why would I abandon the very thing that saved me? You know? That's the question. It's a good song right here. It's a good song. No. That's for cheating me on this speaker. You are the one that I adore. Cause you are the one that I can't stop listening to this song right here. She called her Mr. Bombastic, really fantastic. Put me on the top, she says I'm Mr. Rowe. Romantic, really fantastic. Put me on the top, she says I'm Mr. Rowe. Smooth, just like a silk. I hope you go out and I hope you do your thing every dang day. I love you and I appreciate your friendship and your love and life. See you later, alligator. I'm just like a doctor crawling out of the shell.